Galilee to the Jordan to John to be baptized by him. John would have prevented him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me? But Jesus answered him, Let it be so now, for thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he consented. And when Jesus was baptized, immediately he went up from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and coming to rest on him. And behold, a voice from heaven said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. This, O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading is from Romans, the 6th chapter. What shall we say then? Are we to continue in sin that grace may abound? By no means. How can we, who died to sin, still live in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him in order that the body of sin might be brought to nothing, so that we would no longer be enslaved to sin. For one who has died has been set free from sin. Now if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. For the death he died to sin once for all. But the life he gives, he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
We sing responsibly our responsory.
Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch.
Proclaimed the kingdom of God which was coming into the world. And then Jesus Here at last was the true seed promised from the beginning. Here was life. Though he was among them, the world could not see who Jesus truly was. For Israel, the present circumstances were as a daily grim reminder of their much more glorious past. They remembered the days of David and Solomon when they were a mighty nation, united, powerful. But that was then. Now they're under the thumb of yet one more foreign empire, Rome. But they did not and could not see who this man really was as he came to the Jordan to be baptized. By all outward appearances, he seemed to be just one more man coming to the shores to be baptized by John. In fact, he was less esteemed than most, simply because he was from Nazareth. When Jesus called Philip to follow him, and Philip went to tell Nathanael about Jesus, Nathanael's response was fantastic. He summed up the social standing surrounding Jesus of Nazareth. He asked his brother, "Can anything good come from Nazareth?" It's kind of like us and some of the other suburbs. We're awesome here in Buck House, right? We talk bad about some of the others. Can anything good come from that? Yet here this man was, the seed, the root of Jesse's fruit. Hidden from the human eye, but still present, was the very life and purpose that it gave. The Lord had raised up a prophet named John to prepare the way for Christ through proclamation and through baptism. Through Palestine ran the Jordan River, a life-giving source, as its waters irrigated the land and quenched the thirst of all. At this river, John stood and preached repentance and baptized all who came to him. Then one day it actually happened. Jesus comes to the Jordan to be baptized. John sees him. He recognizes him. He states that he, John, should be baptized by Jesus. Yet Jesus came to fulfill all righteousness. At the Jordan River, the truth of who Jesus was revealed, no matter what the human eye saw in this Nazareth. St. Matthew tells us, "And when Jesus was baptized, immediately he went up from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and coming to rest on him. And behold, a voice from heaven said, 'This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased.'" Human life can seem to be lived in an arid and barren world. We dream of better days where we imagine either A, existed in some long ago past, or what a lot of people think is we're going towards these better days. But in truth, in many ways, the golden eras of the past were not quite as golden as we would imagine. People then, as now, struggled for meaning. They struggled for hope. Society wrestled with morality and oppression. The church struggled to find her voice and identity in the midst of an unbelieving world. As the old adage has it, the more things change, the more they stay the same. Yet just as Palestine had the Jordan River in its midst, so too do we as the church have our source of life-giving water. Always present, even in our darkest days of past, in present, and in the future, is the font of water with the Word. As the church prays in the rite of holy baptism, and if any of you want to come next Monday night, we'll be having baptism right here. As the church prays, through the baptism in the Jordan of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to be a blessed flood and a lavish washing away of sin. Humble water is applied through the all too human hands of a called and ordained servant of Christ. At the word and command of the one baptized in the Jordan, just as the glory of Jesus was clothed in human flesh, so the glory of baptism is cloaked in your water. Here is the unseen but eternal truth of your baptism, expressed in the words so beautifully by St. Paul. "We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life." Here is life, true life, arising from the holy waters of baptism, sanctified by Jesus himself, the light of the world. The world had long awaited Abraham prepared to offer up his son, the promise to the Lord. God provided the substitute. As generations passed, the promise of redemption was never rescinded. A promised seed was carried by the patriarchs Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, through Jesse, through David, all the way to Mary, their descendant. And in Jesus, Son of Mary and Son of God, the Redeemer came to his broken world. In the midst of death, he came as true life. This is the life that defines you and me in a world of death and sin. It is a life that comes from the Creator and from him alone. It is the life that nourishes the children of God as his word is proclaimed. It is life that comes to the very every altar in every place as the church gathers together to celebrate the Eucharistic feast and as we sing the Sanctus with angels and archangels with all the company of heaven. It is a life that has already defeated our great and final enemy, death. As Jesus is baptized in the Jordan, our own baptism is made a sure and certain union with Christ in both his death but also his resurrection. Paul tells us, if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. To Jesse's tree came the life of the world, and now that life comes to you and to me. Thanks be to God. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard our hearts and our minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. We rise as we sing together the canticle. And then the magnet afterwards. I'll give Charles a chance to get back to the organ before I start singing. We'll sing together the canticle. sing, can you hear me? We're not going to sing that introduction because it's one we don't normally do, so I'll just speak it. O Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my prayer come to you.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we implore you to hear our prayers and to lighten the darkness of our hearts by your gracious visitation. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
God of life, into this death-marred world, you bring life through Jesus, the resurrection and the life. Fill us with the life of Jesus so that in this world, so often filled with darkness, our lives might shine forth his life and his hope. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, from whom come all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Here in West Dallas that that helps abused women get back on their feet and get some election resources and stuff like that. The West Dallas Police Department is doing a drive for them for new clothing and stuff like that. So we committed to a certain amount of stuff that we were trying to provide for them. There's a table back in the narthex with a little basket. We put in for private choice dollars, and we're using whatever else gets donated to get as much stuff to help these ladies as we can. So what we're asking, the private shirts are back